Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me, I'm excited because whenever I dive into the nether reaches of my iPhone or of iOS, I always find new and unexpected and sometimes very pleasurable ways of doing things. And it's best when I get to share that with friends. So today, unexpected pleasures in iOS on Dotto Tech. All right, we have seven things to go through today, so we've got lots of little tips to teach you about. Now, these are all things that perhaps you know about, but perhaps you don't. But I think they're all useful ways to get more out of our mobile device, in this case, our iPhone. Now, this is the first one I really was a joy to discover. It's in the notifications area. Now, notifications happen when you swipe from the very top of the screen down. And that basically, regardless of what you're doing in the iPhone, it brings up all of your notifications that are being delivered to you. Now, these are typically text messages or emails that are coming into your system, and we see them all listed here. But the cool thing is, and it's good to just be able to see exactly what notifications are coming into your system, but here is where it gets better. If you swipe from the right side of your screen to the left on any one of these messages, if it's a Gmail or an email, you can reply or archive it directly from the notification screen. So you can do a certain amount of email triage if you just want to archive messages so that they aren't in your inbox next time you go in and you've noticed them, you can do it. Or if there's something urgent, you can go reply to it right now as well, and that launches your email client and allows you to reply immediately to the message. Very cool, I think you'll agree. But it goes beyond just emails, and actually you can just test every message type. Lots of message types, like my message from Agora Pulse. It's just a message here. But look here, I've got a message that came in as a text message. If I swipe to the left there, I can actually go in and reply to that. So again, I don't have to exit the notification screen, launch messages in order to reply to a text message. No, I can just reply directly from here. Very cool. I think you will agree. Next up, we're going to talk about batteries. And our battery life on our smart devices, frankly, sucks for most of us. But we can improve things. Now, if you go into the settings in the iPhone, they've got a new setting there, or they've got a battery setting there where you can go into your battery setting. And the interesting thing to look at is the battery usage. If you take a look there, it will tell you what apps are using what percentage of your battery consumption over what period of time. And you can see here that over the last 7 days and over the last 24 hours, I've had a different variety of apps use up my time. And if we tap on any of them, it brings up the exact amount of time that it actually has used, both in the foreground and in the background. So this is a great little bit of sleuthing work that you can do to see exactly what's running in the background, which is the real insidious battery drain. You know pretty much what you're on and what you're using and how much battery it's draining just because you're using the app. So the ones that are on the screen at the time, that's fairly self-evident. It's what it does in the background that kind of gives you an idea of how you can better manage your apps. So this is a great way for you to look at things. Next up, I want to show you some features in our messages screen. Now, when we go into any thread in messages, if we look at the very top of that message thread, these are basically texts that we've been sending back and forth, we have a details screen. If we go into the details, we've got a variety of different really valuable information available to us. Now, this is where we go to do things like change the contact information in our contact list. But also here is a roster of all of the different attachments that we've sent to that person. What are attachments? Things like photos and videos that we might have sent. Even the instant ones that we do right within the messaging app are here and available to us. So if you need to find a photo that you sent to a friend by text and you can't quickly find it in the camera roll, a quicker way is to go into the details screen and you'll find it there is basically a catalog of all of the images or all of the videos that you've shared with that individual. Very cool. I think you will agree. But even more cool are the location services. Now, these work in two ways. Under location, we can send my current location. And this is what you'd use if, say, you were at a coffee shop. A friend says, hey, Steve, where are you? I said, well, I'm right here. I tap on send my current location, and it sends a text to that individual with a map pin, including the current location, so they can navigate to you immediately and effortlessly. The other option here is share my location, which does the same sort of thing, but it does it on a continuous an ongoing basis, so you can track where a person is or where their phone is at any time. This is incredibly valuable. Let's say a family's on vacation. few of you want to go grab a bite. A few of you want to go shopping. You've agreed to meet at a third location afterwards. If you turn on share my location with each other, you can track where each of the groups are in real time. This adds it's very convenient, but it also adds a great level of security to your family unit as you're doing this. So these two location services, awesome. Now, to be fair, share my location is a bit of a battery hog, but what's a little bit of battery juice compared to knowing where your loved ones are at all times? Now, before we leave the messages area, I want to talk about video and audio messages, which is something that I've not used a lot. Perhaps you have. But if we look on the left-hand side of when we go in to type a text message, we see we have the camera icon there, which will allow us to grab our camera and share an image or take a picture and share it with whoever we're texting to. But did you know that if you just press and hold down on that, up will come the ability for you to take a photo automatically or go up and actually record a video. And as long as my thumb is over top of this, I'm recording a video, which I can then take and automatically share with the person I'm texting. How freaking cool is that? Stop. Now I could send Shannon, I'm sure she won't appreciate it, this video of me just ranting about how cool this is. She wouldn't, of course, know exactly what I'm talking about, so I won't do that. But that same functionality is available in the audio side. If we just tap on the other side, the microphone icon, and it starts recording, and now we're recording a voiceover, which we can then send to whoever it happens to be, a little voice message. So we have the ability to record both audio and video messages. Now, one cool aspect of this is you can actually set these messages to expire, sort of like the early days of Snapchat. So you can send it to somebody and say that it only lasts for 2 hours before it expires. So go back into settings. We go down till we find messages, and in messages, we scroll down to audio messages and video messages, and you see there, we can tell them to expire after a period of time, so that we then have the ability to have, not to be a clogging things up, but to be sent, to be able to send those instant messages that are time sensitive as well. So that is a very cool aspect that we have for video and audio messages in our messaging area. The very last thing I am going to show you in this cornucopia of interesting iPhone and iOS tricks is a Siri trick. Siri, of course, the voice recognition tool built in. And we know that if we press and hold our home button down for a moment, that it will invoke Siri, and then we can ask Siri something. But there's also a voice recognition or a voice activation feature built in that you have to turn on that allows you to use Siri in a completely hands-free mode. So watch what happens. What happens is you say the word, "Hi Siri, hey Siri, hey Siri." And then Siri will wake up and ask you. So watch and be amazed. "Hey Siri, what's the weather going to be like today in Ladner?"
"Today, the temperature will range from 8 degrees to 15.
"Thank you. "Hey Siri, when is my next vet appointment?"
"Your next appointment is at 2:30 p.m. Tuesday."
I've got an English Siri. It sounds so much more sophisticated as an assistant, don't you think? So there were, I have to show you how to find that. Sorry, I got all excited about showing you Siri, and then I didn't show you how to find that. So you go back into settings, and within settings, you go into general, and within general, you find Siri, and if you you have a little toggle switch right there that allows you to use "Hey Siri." The odd time Siri's woken up unbidden, such as I think when I say the word maybe history or something like that, Siri then, well, there it is. Siri will then wake up at that particular point. But for the most part, it's tremendously useful if you want to have full hands-free access to Siri occasionally. And with that, our seven hidden or seven very cool iOS features that you probably didn't know about is now complete. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. And the second, I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. That way you hear about any upcoming webinars, tutorials, and trainings that we have. Dotto Tech is also a community-funded channel supported through the generosity of you folks through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, discover exactly what your support means to our channel, and what perks are available to you. And the perks are indeed awesome. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.